in 1498, Vasco da Gama landed over here in India. His boats bedraggled, his men ravaged with scurvy. 522 years later, I have arrived here in fine form, thanks to this car, all the way from Bombay. This is Kerala. Welcome to Kerala. Bichara Vasco was up against malaria and Malayalam to find his way around Kerala to meet the Zamorin. But thanks to Google Maps, my plan was sorted. First, I would head to the lush rainforest of Wayanad in the Western Ghats, then to the lesser-known Natika Beach. From there, I would turn south to meet an old colleague at Mundakayam. Next would be the tranquil avian haven of Kumarakom, before finishing off at Fort Cochin, where old Vasco dropped dead on Christmas Eve 1524. Due to its geography, Wayanad has a microclimate. And sure enough, even though the monsoons were a month away, I encountered a thunderstorm as soon as I started up the hills. Morning, I drove to a local football field where Pradeep Murthy from Muddy Boots Adventures was waiting for me. Hi Pradeep.
Hey Rishad.
How are you?
Nice to meet you.
Yeah, same here.
How's things?
Good. It was a long drive, but I'm here finally.
The plan was to go cycling, but for that, the cycle had to first be transported. Of course, that wasn't a problem with the moving house kind of boot space that the ND affords.
I'll just put the seats down. No, no, why you want to remove the front wheel?
Arre,
nahin, yaar. I'll put the middle row also down and there'll be enough room.
Okay.
Don't remove it.
Then came my coolie number one moment as I carried the cycle from the ford to the bamboo raft. Drifting down the Anoth Puza was a definite highlight of that day. I had been on the go for 3 days, propelled by diesel, and now to just sit back and float to the whims of the current and a barge pole was a refreshing change of pace. Just as I was thinking that I could do this all day, we arrived at the landing point, from where I had to carry the cycle up the steep bank to the trail. But the trail itself was level, and the recent thunderstorms had tempered the summer heat. Besides that, the fresh green of the tea shrubs were a pretty accompaniment as I pedaled the mud tracks towards the roadhead. End of my cycling trail met the road where Muddy Boots has its ziplining setup.
Hi.
Hi. How was the cycling?
Cycling was very nice. Lovely estates. Little hot, but very nice. So I can do this ziplining? Sure. It'll take my weight. Definitely. Won't break, no? Okay. Sure, 100%. Alright. Okay, let's do it.
that was awesome! I'm so glad I did it.
After that active day out, it was good to come back to the comfort of Wayanad Wild. This comfortable property is situated deep in the heart of a Western Ghat rainforest without any set boundaries. So the forest flora and fauna are constant companions. Some balconies look out over treetops, while others might afford views of distant wild elephants. There is also an infinity pool to soak away the rigors of the day. You could certainly say that my Kerala road trip was on to a good start with the promise of even more adventure to come. Do check out episode 2.